So we're finishing up week five of 40 Days of Prayer, and this week's word was connecting. And that's connecting with one another, connecting new people who are coming in, connecting within the body of Christ, loving one another, encouraging one another, challenging one another. It's all of those one another sorts of things. And the verses for today are Ephesians chapter 1, beginning in verse 15, going through 23. And this is a prayer that Paul is using to pray for the Ephesians. And I will often use prayers of the Bible as a guide for my own prayer. Sometimes I will just use the prayer itself and just say it back to the Lord. But I'm going to use this as a prayer guide for today. So if you've got your Bible, you may want to open it to Ephesians chapter 1 just to see how I am using this as a prayer guide. I do want to point out one phrase that I think is really important to this theme of connecting. And that is in verse 18, it says, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you. And then it says this, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. Part of Paul's prayer is that people would see the riches of God's people, see the riches of the body of Christ. I mean, it's the riches of God's inheritance. So God looks at the body of Christ, looks at the family of God, looks at the believers, and sees it as his inheritance. And so my part of my prayer is that we will see within our churches just the riches that are there, and that will cause us to be grateful. So with that in mind, let me pray through Ephesians chapter 1, beginning in verse 15. For this reason, ever since I heard about your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all God's people, I have not stopped giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. And so, Lord, I pray, I thank you, Lord, for the people of Genesis. I thank you for the churches of Genesis. I thank you for the pastors of Genesis. I thank you for the faith that has been exercised this past year. I thank you for the faith that has allowed us to get through a very difficult year. I thank you for the faith that has caused us to step into new territory, into doing ministry, into new ways, into reaching out to people in different ways. And I thank you not only for the faith that I've seen exhibited, but I thank you for the love that I've seen exhibited, for the love that God's people have for one another, the love and the care that they have in their churches and in small groups and for their pastors. And I thank you for this love that has been shown. And so I thank you for the people of Genesis. Verse 17, I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know better. And so, Lord, I ask, Abba, Father, that you would give us your spirit of wisdom and revelation, and that we would know you better. And so in the midst of this crazy time, I pray that we would have eyes to see the way that you're already at work, that we would have eyes to see the ways that you're going ahead of us, that we would have eyes to see what you are doing among us, and that we would have wisdom how to respond, that we would know what those next steps are, that you would be intuitively directing us to do what you want us to do and to be who you want us to be. Verse 18, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you. So I pray, Lord, that you would be giving us eyes to see the hope which you've called us to. Even in a time when very few people have a lot of hope, I pray that we would be people of hope. And our hope wouldn't depend on whether or not something's open or closed, but our hope would depend upon you. Would you make us people of hope? Would you help us to see that you, the hope that you hold out for us, no matter what is going on in the world? And then continuing on, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you and the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. And so, Lord, I pray we would see the riches of your people. We would see the riches of the body of Christ, that we would look at our churches with great love and appreciation, that we would see the gifts that are there, that we would see those who have mentored us. We would see the places where you're inviting us to serve. I pray that we would just be incredibly grateful at the riches that we see in our churches. And then, Lord, I pray, it says 19, verse 19, and his incomparably great power for us who believe. And I pray that we would see the power that you have for us, the power that you hold out to us, and that we would grab a hold of that power, the power, same power that raised Christ from the dead. I pray that we would grab a hold of that power and we would be operating in that power with one another, together with one another, on your mission for your kingdom. Lord, I thank you for Genesis, and I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. That that's a passage that I often pray for Genesis, and I will continue to do so, and I invite you to join with me. Have a great day, friends.